Howdy folks, how you doing? Kel here. Well, look, I've got a package to open up. Look, it's as big as my big fat head. My big fat Irish head. Anyway, I did that pipe auction video here a while ago. And this is the pipe I bought. I bought that Chiracco bent pipe. Word about this. I actually got this last Thursday. Today is Tuesday. I got it Thursday and wanted to open it on Thursday, but I wanted it open on camera and I was not able to get in front of a camera. So I, just for you folks, my viewers, I want you to know I have been holding this package in my room, between my legs actually, just like that, for 4 days. 5 days, I've been holding it for 5 days in my room so I could open it on camera. And really honestly, I know I have not opened it. Last couple days I've just been going, gonna open that package. I've been jonesing to open that package, but got the big knife. And no, it's not a switchblade, it's just a German, it says roast fry on the blade, which means rust free. If you ever have a knife that says roast fry, it means rust free. It is a German knife, made in Germany. Anyway, let's open up here. If you remember that video, if you haven't seen the video, you can go back and watch it. It's a few videos before this one. I was actually looking at a Costello pipe one of mine on eBay, and I made a video about should I buy a new pipe in relation to that pipe, actually. Then I saw this one. This is a Chiracco pipe, and I ended up buying this one. Ow, I just took myself in the leg with my knife. Damn it, I was trying to close it like this, just took myself in the damn leg. Son of a bitch. It's not bleeding anything. That's good. Yeah, anyway. We'll keep an eye on that. It's cut, though. Anyway. So anyway, without further ado, let's take this out, or try to. Stuck together a little bit. The knife again. I'm going to cut myself again with my knife. That's a frequent experience of mine. I'm always cutting myself with knives. Because mother never loved me. No, that's not why. Because I'm clumsy. I'm clumsy. I'm a clumsy guy. Yeah. Drama going around the background. Well, there's the bowl. Put that down. Get the other part down here. Some moron yelling in the background. The dog, no doubt. We have idiots who walk dogs over in this forest over here behind me. They're a nuisance to me. I love dogs. People who have them are nuisances to me in my area. Sometimes. Yeah, that's interesting. Well, that's gross. Anyway, there's the pipe. I'm going to put it together just to... It goes together pretty easily. That's nice. End here is all gooey looking. When I rubbed it, a bunch of goo come off it. Jeez Louise. Focus back on me. I noticed several things about this pipe in the video, which in the pictures, which concerned me. One of which I still see here. It looked like there was a dent here in the pipe, or something. It looks like it's just a mark. You know, now, I'm not going to say some things here. I'm not going to put down the guy I bought the pipe from. But I noticed this pipe looked unclean. I mean, like even dusty, like it is indeed dusty in there. Can you see that? It's very dusty right in there. Whoever sold this pipe, and I don't mean to embarrass him, you know, but he seemed like a nice enough guy. He didn't really answer my questions about it or anything, though. It's dirty in through here. This rim is blackened. You see right there, it's black. I got a good deal on this. I paid $89. There's no dent there, which I'm really relieved. I thought there was a dent. It looks like it's just dirt of some kind. And that's a good thing, believe it or not. He didn't clean up anything. I mean, it's even got like goo. Looks like chapstick or something, like goo in the damn thing up here. So I don't see any real bite marks in the stem, though, it looks like. Anyway, it's good that it was dirty and unkept and uncleaned. It's not English tobacco, and that's good because I'm not going to be smoking English in this. It is good that it's this way, and I'll tell you why. Because it's what I call an honest pipe. So many pipes on eBay are really, they're all fixed up, you know what I'm saying? The owner or the buyer, like the professional sellers, nothing against them, but they, if there's teeth marks in the stem, they take it to a grinding wheel or whatever, and a polishing wheel, and they polish it down, which also makes this thinner and more fragile. And they make them clean up really, really nice, and make them look like new as they can. Kind of like when a car dealer does that to a car. It's not a good thing, in my opinion, if you're buying a pipe. You're better off buying a pipe from somebody who did what this guy did, you know. He didn't bother cleaning it up. It looked rather kind of ratty in the ad. It didn't look very good in the pictures. It doesn't look that great here now. But the reason why I wanted to show this to you when I first got it is because I'm going to take this pipe and clean it up. I'm going to clean it all up and kind of restore it a little bit. And I see it now. Again, you see the dirt on there? Right there on the pipe? I've got some behind me here making noise. But, you know, I'll clean that all off, of course, just dust. And I'll sanitize it with some alcohol on the stem. I don't know that I'm going to need to do an alcohol cleaning on it. I can see, we should put a light out here. I can see it's, you know, the bowl looks really pretty clean, actually. I don't know how many times you smoke, probably not that many times. And I'll clean whatever goo there is on here, if it'll come off. It's a coral dot, by the way. Can you see that there, rather than the little J? Most of your aquabowls these days have the little J on it, but this has a coral dot. And that's fine, coral dot's fine. It's coral with a little silver ring on the outside. But it's got the little wooden insert here, which is more expensive on these pipes. But overall, it looks pretty good. I'm glad to see this wasn't a dent. I could barely see in the pictures. It looked like there was a dent here. That's good. It just looks like it's maybe some filth or some kind or other. The whole pipe really is got a lot of dust and stuff in the sandblaster ring, and that's a good thing. I can take a brush and very lightly clean all that off. This mark here, which is from smoking, looks like it's not so much a burn, it's just goo. If I had a napkin out here, I would just work on it right now with a little bit of saliva. That's all I'll take. I'll alcohol clean the inside of the stem here. It's kind of gross. It's maybe the grossest pipe I've ever actually received, actually, to tell you the honest truth. But that's, again, it's okay. You know, when you're buying a pipe from a dealer who's you know, polished the stem up and stuff and got any teeth marks out and all this other stuff, you don't really know what condition it was in, really. You know, and you're going to pay more because it looks all nice and brand new. I saw a pipe the other day which they obviously polished the shank and stuff here, and because of that, the fit between the stem and the shank here no longer fit anymore. They didn't meet up tightly. You could tell they weren't no longer really symmetrical very much. And that's why I say this is an honest pipe. I paid $89 for it. This is I believe a Maxima. It says it somewhere. It's a Maxima, which means it's the bigger size of a Chicago pipe. It's a pretty good size pipe. And you know, it's probably a $300 pipe, new, or $350, maybe $400, depending where you buy it. In the United States, probably $350, maybe $400, I don't know. Over in Europe, it'd be cheaper. But so I got it for $89, and when I'm done with this pipe, I can kind of see down inside the bowl. I wish I had a flash with me. I'm sorry about that. The bowl looks pristine, except for it's been smoked a few times. And I'm not going to stick my finger down there. I could. The bowl looks pretty much like pristine, so I'll just take a swab, an alcohol swab, and swab it around a little bit. I mean, I don't even see much in the way of cake. I'll see some blackening in there. I'm hoping this will come off. But overall, I got what I paid for and what I knew I was going to get. If it had been all cleaned up and polished, you know, I think I could take this pipe, frankly, and with my good little camera I'm using right now, which takes very good pictures for eBay, I suspect I could take this pipe and clean it up really well, and probably at least $154 is my guess. I'm not doing that. I don't buy pipes to resell them, but I'm sure I could get more money out of this pipe than I paid for it. Once this is cleaned off, all the dust is cleaned off, and some really good photographs, which this camera will take, I could probably make money on this pipe, and I feel like I got a good deal. No buyer's remorse here, but I'm making a video about buyer's remorse because it's on my mind, because you know, I've had that a few times with pipes and things. I'm not putting all the way back together because I want to take and take some graphite and paint the stem there as it goes in so it doesn't stick. I recommend you do it with all your pipes. Take a pencil, and I've made a video on this, but just draw on there with, you know, with graphite pencil, so it's a little slicker, so it's not going to stick and break your thing. I actually broke a pipe tenon after making that video. I have a little more of a granny that I actually broke. I didn't bother to do. I don't think I did that one or something, but I was taking it apart and snap, the broke off right there. Really sucks. I was able to kind of fix it, kind of, but well, it's pretty good, guys, all in all. I'll put this back here one more time for you. It's a little sticky there, but if you look at this together, here, if you can get this to work, the camera to work, it's magic. So, definitely zoomed in there. It's brown, which is nice. I wanted brown. It looked brown to me in the pictures. It matches that for one thing, but also all the sandblasts I've got is black, except for a tan one. I don't have any brown sandblasts, which is kind of cool. This pipe, one of the reasons I was interested in this, besides the fact I thought it'd be a good deal in a Ciaccopo and a Maxima, was this is pretty much the same exact shape as the first pipe I ever owned, which was a Savinelli, which is a nice smoker. I smoked it for years and years. All I smoked that my little thing, but that's nice. Well, that's it. Hope you enjoyed the box opening, folks, and thanks for watching. And like I say, what I'll probably do, well, there's not much to do in this pipe. I'm not sure if I'll bother showing it on camera. I was going to restore it on camera and on video, but I'm not sure what I'll do. I might. There's not much to really do. I got to wipe the bowl out, clean that off, and, you know, I'll just do that with a little bit of saliva. But, you know, it's just a little bit of very light cleaning, really. And I'll run an alcohol, you know, pipe cleaner through this. Really good to get that all cleaned out and all. Alcohol, this really good. Gonna have to be careful though, because this wood here, if alcohol hits that wood is gonna go away. It'll ruin that wood. It'll destroy it instantly. It'll look like crap. It'll just take the finish right off there. So I'm gonna have to be very careful with that. I may even wrap this in plastic. You know, maybe tape it or something. I don't know, to protect that, because that's very difficult. That'll screw it up in a hurry. You know, so. I don't know if I'll do that on camera or not. I'll have to decide. I kind of want to get this cleaned up so I can smoke it. Not tonight, but I do kind of want to get this cleaned up so I can actually be puffing on it, because I don't have any Ciaccopos that are quite this style and everything else. I'm kind of looking forward to it. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys and gals. And I may make a series, but I've cleaned Pisces 4 on camera, so. But the bowl in this looks really pretty good, at least as far as I can see down in there. It looks just like it's been smoked a few times, but not dozens and dozens of times. You know, look at this here. It's more of a red color, a burgundy color, than a brown, actually, which is going to be pretty. Once this is cleaned up, if you can see it on there again, but once this is cleaned up, this more of a burgundy color. That's even prettier. That's even better. See, again, if I'd known this burgundy, I'd want it even more. And again, I gotta say, if he cleaned this pipe up really good and taking good photographs, but they weren't good photographs. And, you know, this would have gone over $100, no doubt in my mind. Probably 150, maybe even two. Could have even gone a couple $100, you know. Tempted to put it back on eBay and see how far it goes. And just before the auction ends, cancel the auction. I would never do that. But I'd be curious. I just want to see how much it was going to go for. I would never do that. But I know it being more money than I paid for it. It'll be a little work cleaning up and, you know. But whatever. All right, well, that's it. Enough of this. Enough yakking. Thanks for watching, guys and gals. And you'll see me smoking this one of these days soon. I really feel like cleaning up tonight and smoking tonight, but I probably won't. I'll talk to you later.